Zack Snyder is making a Star Wars movie? No, not really. Okay, let me tell you what's going on. Guys, if you're new here, like, comment, and subscribe. Comment challenge for today is, what is your favorite Zack Snyder film? Mine, probably, is it Dawn of the Dead? Was probably his best film for me. Then followed by, perhaps, what is this?
Perhaps, what is this?
No, just kidding. Perhaps I'm gonna get crucified for this, but I like to hate watch BVS. Something about the vibe in that movie just gets me going. It's a weird dichotomy I have. It's like that spiteful ex that you keep, you know, screwing around with, but you know you shouldn't. That's BVS for me. Anyways, we're getting sidetracked. Zack Snyder is making a Star Wars movie. No, not really. He's making this project called Rebel Moon. Now, we all know he tried to create his own universe with the DC IP, and it kind of failed. It kind of crumbled. So what's his next step? His next step is the Rebel Moon universe, which is actually something he's been working on for several years now. Behind the scenes, during the shooting of Justice League, during the writing of BVS, he had this idea kind of being sculpted in the background while he was taking on other projects, which is insane. So hopefully this is, you know, his masterpiece that he's been crafting for years and years, and he's finally ready to show us. It's coming to Netflix on December 22nd, and it's a film. It's going to be a series of films, hopefully, if it's successful and they give him the money to make more. But what it is sort of a sci-fi Star Wars samurai warrior-esque, you know, hero's journey, good versus evil, classic space opera story, kind of like Star Wars. There's even Star Wars-esque elements in this trailer that we're going to watch together. And so without further ado, I'm going to show you guys Zack Snyder's Star Wars film trailer, Rebel Moon. Sorry, I keep calling it Zack Snyder's Star Wars. That's a clickbait thing. Hate me. Don't hate me. Leave a like and a comment. Subscribe. Let's watch this thing. Okay. Rebel Moon. Official teaser. Netflix. December 22nd. I've never seen this before, so this is going to be amazing. By the way, I've tried to record this video like 3 times. I can't even speak today for some reason. Maybe I didn't drink enough liquid death. Sponsor me, you sons of... Okay, here we go. Exciting. Is that Hela? From Thor?
Do you know the story of the Princess Issa? In myth, she was called the Redeemer. It was said this child would stop the madness of war. That she was to usher in a new age of peace and compassion. I was given memories of a world I will never see. Loyalty to a king I cannot serve. And love for a child I could not save.
It looks really good.
What do you think they want?
Everything.
Sophia Boutella?
I found her.
Scar child of war. I was taught that love is weakness.
Like space Nazis? Whoa, what is that?
Between justice and revenge.
Whoa, lightsabers.
There is a price to pay for
it's like some
defiance.
Witcher monster.
One moment. I do love this part.
A little bit of humor.
I don't want no trouble.
We're not here to bring any.
Charlie Hunnam.
Are you ready?
Questionable monster CGI, but
I pose no fear.
Who am I to speak?
Let's show them that we're not afraid. Let's show them we are more.
That looks good. That looks really good.
Behind us.
John Carter vibes. Whoa.
A king is a man, and a man can fail. But a myth is indestructible.
Oh.
The time has come for all that you love. Protect each other and show them no mercy.
We'll be right back.
Who among you is willing to die for what you believe?
Rebel Moon. Okay. Part one, A Child of Fire. That's new. So we haven't, I don't think I've seen this subtitle yet. I don't know if anybody's seen it, but it's new to me. Child of Fire. Part two. So they've already got a part two. This is crazy. I think there's going to be a part three, though. I think there's going to be a part three as well. So we're getting one per year. One per year. Only on Netflix. Look, this looks so good. I think they should put it in theaters at least for 30 days or like 2 weeks minimum, like they did with... I mean, look, if Glass Onion can get a, you know, theatrical release, then why not Rebel Moon? You know, why not Rebel Moon? I don't know. Curious. Guys, I don't think I got a lot of the story setup, particularly from this trailer. It was more like a vibes trailer. It felt like just a montage of clips instead of a story being told. Maybe I'm just like cloudy today, but I if you ask me what the story is exactly after watching this, I mean, there's going to be a space rebellion. We got Anthony Hopkins voicing this like droid-esque robotic character, I think. I don't know what his role is exactly. I'm really curious to get more of a story trailer. I mean, this is a teaser trailer, so maybe a teaser trailer is not the actual trailer, and the actual trailer will be like a story trailer. I really want to get a little more setup, but you know, maybe that's not their goal. Maybe they want you to go in like a little more fresh, because a lot of the trailers, you know, I'll complain about telling the story too much, you know. But I don't know. Look at this guy's got crazy tits. Sorry. Guys, the imagery in this trailer is outstanding. There's a CGI moment here and there where I'm kind of questioning. This looks a little bit you know, soundstagey, but still pretty good for... This is great for Netflix. This is gonna be huge. This is gonna get a lot of Snyder boys, Snyder girls, Snyder-esque people's on board for renewing their subscriptions. This is Sophia Boutella, I believe. She hasn't been anything popular in a while. I remember her in Kingsman, I think. This shot right here, you know, you compare this to maybe Dune or even Star Wars. This looks a little bit like After Effects. And when I say that, I mean like, you know, YouTubers, if they spent, you know, a few weeks, could like Corridor Digital could mock this up. I don't know if the CGI is completely done yet. So maybe these shots will look better. This looks amazing. The color grading is all over the place in a good way. Like, there's so many tones. It's not just a one note, you know, one environment movie. There's a lot of worlds, a lot of places we're visiting. This monster looked the best. I'm assuming this monster is going to get a lot of screen time because this one looked so good compared to some of the other ones. It looked insane. Now, if we go over here to the lightsabers, this is what everybody wants. What is it? Ron Jeremy? Is that Ron Jeremy? So they've got like Western style space guns, obviously shooting lasers, but look, it's like a lever action, like MK2 carbine looking thing. Is that the guy that plays Dario? Is that the guy that plays Dario? The first guy from Game of Thrones? The one before the roadie swap? This looked a little cartoony, like Clash of Clans CGI or some shit. I don't know. But, you know, Zack's going to deliver something intriguing at the least. What I'm not getting here, that is the Dario guy. That's the Dario guy. What I'm not getting here is character. I'm not getting a lot of character. We got Dario on the run again. Dario is going to jump on a Pegasus. Bruh. Dog. What is going on in this trailer? I didn't get any sense of character. I wanted a character moment. I feel like he's going to be a very, you know, overwhelming presence on screen. Let's see what he says here.
One moment. I do love this part.
This guy is going to be my... I don't know who this actor is. This guy's going to be my favorite part of the movie. I can already tell. It's crazy. So look at this. Look, it's Dario Naharis version 1 jumping on a black Pegasus. This is amazing. Holy shit. Lightsabers. We need to see those. Oh, wait. Where was that shit? This. Look at this. That, I think this is the Anthony Hopkins robot without his little headdress. Maybe he gets it later. But look at all these lights. What are all these lights? Is this like a firefly? Space fireflies? I don't know. Listen. I have massive ADHD and I feel like this film is going to cure it. Jaimon Hansu always pops up and everything. Charlie Hunnam, amazing, right? Good actors in this. Nobody's going to steal the show. There's no like Robert Downey Jr. in here. So it's going to be more about the story and characters rather than like having an actor putting a name to the film. This looks like our crew. So we're going to be assembling. I'm pretty sure the first part of the movie is going to be assembling the crew. We're going to get Pegasus Man. I don't actually know if that's Dario Naharis, but Pegasus Man, Kingsman Girl, Charlie Hunnam, this dude, and the robot guy. There's going to be like a Seven Samurai vibe to it, right? They're all coming together. They're going to fight the rebellion. They're going to become the rebellion. This looks like some royalty shit going on here. White Pegasus. Is it going to be a White Pegasus versus Black Pegasus moment? What are they farming here? Who knows? The space shots look gorgeous. This is like so Zack Snyder. Like, look at how big that lens flare is. I mean, goddamn. Him and J.J. Abrams both could have a friggin' lens flare baby explode the sun. Anyways, guys, what do you think of this trailer, teaser, Rebel Moon, Zack Snyder, Star Wars? Let me know in the comments down below. I love you 3000. Subscribe, like. I'll see you in the next video.